Desperate plea from the family of a fallen Marine this morning after someone stole his sentimental flag. That flag was draped over Lance Corporal Joe Jackson's bed before he went out on his last patrol in Afghanistan and was killed in action in 2011. The flag also signed by every single member of his platoon, and two of them have died. Three are amputees, and several others were hurt and are dealing now with PTSD. Jackson's father and Marine Corps veteran Sean Marceau joins us now. Sean, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you. Good morning.
You're welcome. I know that every family that loses a loved one fighting for our country pays such a dear price. Tell us about your son, Joe.
Just followed in the line of myself. I served in the Marine Corps. His grandpa served in 68 with the 9th, and his great-grandpa jumped into Normandy. Mm. And so it's in his bloodline, and he's very strong-willed. Young man, or he was a very strong-willed young man.
He was only 22 when he lost his life fighting for our freedoms, and we thank you for that ultimate sacrifice. You posted a story on Facebook, and it got our attention. You posted it on Friday, and on Monday, it was shared 40,000 times. It was about the flag that we mentioned in the intro that was stolen, that was over your son's bed on his last patrol. Tell us about this flag and what it means to you.
Well, I use this flag as a talking point to a lot of people. It's kind of an icebreaker when I'm talking to young vets. They can key in with it and see that they've lost people in battle too. And what it does is they can relate. It helps them open up a little bit. All the people that signed it were from all nationalities. There's no religion, no government to it. It's just small town America. And I think that's what that flag, why it's so important to us, is because it was Joe just being and his around the guys that he loved. That's basically what it was.
So what happened to the flag?
Well, we have a memorial shoot. As a matter of fact, we just passed the anniversary of Joe's when he was killed, and so we have a memorial every year. And leading up to it, I was looking for his flag. Well, my car was broken into before that. I thought I brought it in the house. And we looked into, the memorial was coming up, and I started frantically looking. I couldn't find it. I told my wife, and so we went through the memorial. After that, I kept looking, and I said, oh, no, it was in the truck, because that day we were going to, I actually was going to take it out to get framed. I was showing another vet, and it got stolen. It had to, must have used it to bag their stuff up. So that's how we lost it.
Sean, when you realized that, I'm sure your heart sank. What were your emotions?
Well, first off, I was very upset. I mean, a rage. And then disappointment because I lost it. And then just a last-ditch effort. Friday was a last-ditch effort. Please.
Tell us the area where you live, how we can help as viewers.
Well, I live in White Swan, Washington. That's central Washington in the Yakima Valley, on the Yakima Indian Reservation. And that's why I just said, just share it. If you can share it and bring it out to your local police department, news station, newspaper, however you can do it. Just have somebody turn it in, look in the pawn stores, look in Goodwills, whatever secondhand store you have, it might be there. I know this is a last-ditch effort, but it means everything to us. It means everything to the 17 that were killed in that deployment. Means everything to all those 190 that were wounded that time. It doesn't just touch me; it touches a lot of people. You know, especially my family, but a lot of the Marines that served with Joe. They would like it back, and wherever we can get it back.
Sean, Joe's story is touching to all of us. Unfortunately, his life was cut short at 22 years old. What does his service mean to you?
It wasn't a selfless sacrifice. Well, he served honorably as a Marine. He was where he wanted to be. He was surrounded by the loved ones that he wanted to be around. And when he died, he was carried by men that loved him. And so I think his service just shows the love we have. You know, the guy to your left, the guy to your right. You know, we got each other six.
It's a beautiful message. Sean Marceau, thank you for your sacrifice. God bless your family.
Thank you.